Hello students, we were discussing about compass surveying and right now today's class will be on one of the very important topic of your entire module, you can say. So apart from the difference between prismatic compass and surveyor's compass, this is one more important topic which you are going to study today. And the topic for today is local attraction. The word local attraction has been derived to denote the influence of foreign material which prevent the needle from showing the correct magnetic north. So generally what happens is when you will be working with the compass in the field, so you will take the compass, you fix it at some point. Then when you want to measure the bearing of certain line, the magnetic needle and its accuracy, or the magnetic needle and its what you can say sensitivity, it depends on numerous factors in and around the locality. The factors or the materials which influence the magnetic needle from showing the correct north, that is the correct magnetic north, are the metals. Generally when you find any metal nearby, any compass or any magnetic needle, so definitely the needle may not be showing you the correct north. So it doesn't happen only with the prismatic compass or any kind of compass. Any magnetic needle you take or any magnet you take, it always behave independently when it is away from the metals. But as soon it is very near to the magnetic material or any metals nearby, and definitely the magnet may not show the true north. So in such cases what happens is instead of showing the correct magnetic north, the magnetic needle might slightly show a different direction. So you can say that there might be an error in the bearings which are measured with that particular compass. So the word local attraction has been the word which is used to denote the influence of such materials for showing or which prevents the needle from pointing to the magnetic north. So those materials are being listed here, the materials which are having the needle preventing the needle from pointing magnetic north are generally the metals. It might be anything, like if you are working with the compass nearby any compound, so the compound may have the metal grills, or sometimes even the metal gate nearby may influence the magnetic needle from showing the correct north. And even sometimes the magnetite present in the ground or the earth, so there might be number of ores present in the earth's crust or inside the ground. So such materials, when they have the magnetite, which is nothing but an ore for the iron, so if at all if it is present, then the magnetic needle may not show the correct north. Or sometimes even the electric wire carrying electric current inside, that may also affect the magnetic needle from showing the correct north. And if at all if the building nearby is of steel structures, or sometimes the rails or underground iron pipes, so these are the large structures which influences the magnetic needle from showing the correct north. So not only these, even the smallest metal nearby, like so if you have your keys kept inside the pocket while working with the compass, or if you have the metal chain or silver chain or golden chain bearing, or if you are wearing finger rings, or sometimes even the metal present in the spectacles can also affect the magnetic needle from showing the correct north. So these are some of the materials which influence the magnetic needle from showing the correct north. This influence is denoted by the word local attraction. Local attraction means it is the word which is used to denote the influence of such materials which prevents the magnetic needle from showing the correct north, right? So this is what is local attraction. So when if I am taking the compass and if I am working on the field with the compass, I should make sure that I don't have any metal nearby, or if I or I don't have any chains or some kind of metals with me carrying while working with the compass. So as far as possible, you are supposed to be away from such materials which influence the compass magnetic needle from showing the correct north. So most of the times this becomes unavoidable. So you may have to work under the influence of such materials. Even when you work with such influencing materials, it is still possible to get the correct bearing. And such problems we are going to see in the future slides. So you need to understand what is local attraction first. So this is the introduction of local attraction. So let us move ahead and let us see how to identify and rectify the bearings observed. So first you need to understand whether there is a local attraction present in the carried out work. So what exactly that means is, if I go and work in the field with the help of compass, I have measured number of bearings from the compass. After finishing my work, when I have the fore bearings and back bearings of all the lines which I have observed, I should be able to first identify whether there is a local attraction present or not. Local attraction present or not, in the sense what? Whether the needle shown by, the north shown by the magnetic needle is the correct magnetic north or not. So if it is not, then definitely there is a local attraction. So how to detect that is, so when you will be working with the compass in the field, you are going to measure the fore bearing and back bearing of the line. So when you are measuring the fore bearing and back bearing, definitely you cannot say that I will measure only the fore bearing. So whenever you work with the compass, it is always recommended that you measure fore bearing as well as back bearing. Why? Because sometimes if the bearings are incorrect, like if fore bearing is incorrect, then using the correct back bearing you can still rectify the error. Or when fore bearing is correct and if back bearing is incorrect, then you can rectify the back bearing because you know that the fore bearing is correct. So it is always advised to measure both the fore bearings as well as back bearings whenever you carry out any work with the compass. So if I have the fore bearings and back bearings measured for my work, so I have taken the compass to the field, I have number of lines on the ground, so I kept the compass on different points and I have measured the fore bearing and back bearings of all the lines. Now when I have the data over my paper, I will be having the line AB, so and so fore bearing, so and so back bearing. Then I have line BC, written fore bearing and back bearing. CD, DE, like whatever number of lines I have the fore bearings and back bearings noted down in the paper. And if I have to check whether all the bearings are correct or not, or if there are any bearings which are incorrect because of the local attraction, then what I need to do is, I need to continue the table with one more column. I need to introduce one more column. So in the column which is introduced, I am going to write the difference between fore bearing and back bearing. So I have the fore bearing of line AB, I have the back bearing of line AB. I will see what is the difference between the two. So in the previous classes you have seen that the difference between fore bearing and back bearing should be exactly 180 degree. So that is the reason why I am going to calculate the difference between fore bearing and back bearing. So if fore bearing and back bearing difference, when you get from the observed bearings, so if it is exactly 180 degree, then definitely you can say that there is no local attraction. So the stations are free from local attraction, you can say. And when you found the difference, and if the difference is not 180 degree, if you get any other value other than 180 degree, then definitely you can say that either both or one out of the two have the local attraction. So I am talking about only that particular line. So one line will have one fore bearing and one back bearing. Fore bearing will be measured at the starting point of the line. Back bearing will be measured at the end point of the line. So either both the values might be wrong, fore bearing as well as back bearing. So if both the values are wrong, that means what? Both the stations are affected by local attraction. You never know. So only with the help of difference, you cannot identify which station has the local attraction, right? But you can say that there is a local attraction either in both the stations or in any one of the two stations. So this is the way how you find out the local attraction, if it is present or not. So how it is to be done? You need to find out the difference between fore bearing and back bearing, see whether it is 180 degree or not. If it is 180 degree, then there is no local attraction. If it is not 180 degree, then there is a local attraction. So let us see how to rectify the local attraction if it is present. So how to eliminate the local attraction? So there are two methods of correcting the bearings which are observed. So now you have measured the bearings, and when you have found the difference between the two, you found that the difference between the fore bearing and back bearing is not 180 degree. Then that means what? There is a local attraction. So when there is a local attraction, then how to rectify that or how to eliminate that? In the first method, what we do is we will find out which has got 180 degree difference. For an example, if I have four different lines lying on the ground, namely AB, BC, CD, DE. So if there are four lines lying on the ground, line AB has got fore bearing and back bearing, BC also has got fore bearing and back bearing, so also CD and DE. So all the four lines will have fore bearings and back bearings. So the difference I will find out for all the four. So difference between fore bearing and back bearing has to be found. So line AB might have given a different difference, like one, it is not giving you 180 degree difference. Line BC might not also give you 180 degree difference. Line CD may give you 180 degree difference, and line DE might not give you 180 degree. So out of the four lines, only line CD is giving you 180 degree difference. So what exactly that mean? That means line CD, both fore bearings and back bearings are correct. That is the reason why the fore bearing and back bearing difference is 180 degree. So by knowing this, you will come to know that two stations are free from local attraction, which are those two, C and D, because line CD is giving you the difference of fore bearing and back bearing exactly 180 degree. So station C and station D are free from local attraction. So by knowing the two values which are correct, or two stations which are free from local attraction, you can calculate the bearings of other stations by knowing what is the error in each station. So you are going to solve problems on this, so you will be able to understand the method correctly when we solve one of the problem on this method, right? And in today's class, I am going to show you how this particular bearing is, I mean how these problems are being solved by using the first method. In the second method, what we do is we will find out the interior angles. So you know how to find out the interior angles when the bearings are known. So we have solved number of problems on this. So when the bearings are given, you can calculate the interior angles. So second method is generally adopted for a closed travels. So in a closed traverse, sum of interior angles will be equal to 2n minus 4 into 90. So if there are 4 sides, then 2 into 4, n will be equal to 4. So those mean 2 into n, that is 4. So it becomes 2 into 4, 8. 8 minus 4 is 4. So 4 into 90, 360. So sum of the interior angles should be equal to 360 degree. So based on the bearings which are observed, you are going to calculate the interior angles, and those interior angles should be added. So if the bearings are correct, then once again you will get the sum of interior angles equal to 360 degree, or whatever the number of sides are. So if it is 5 sides, then it will be 540, right? So if it is 4 sides, then it is 360 degree. So when you add all the interior angles, you should get 360 degree. If you are getting 360 degree, that means what? All the bearings are correct. So if you are not getting 360 degree, so for an example, if you are getting 361 degree, so that means what? There is an error. So how this error is being distributed? Then the error is being distributed to all the interior angles, right? So 1 degree is the error. So there are 4 interior angles and there is an error of 1 degree. So 1 degree divided by 4, so that will be 15 minutes. So 15 minutes will be subtracted from all the interior angles because you have 361 degree as interior angles. So the correct interior sum of interior angles will be 360 degree. So you are getting 361. So all the interior angles have to be subtracted by 1/4 of the total error. So 1/4 of the total error is 15 minutes because the total error is 1 degree. So 1 degree will have 60 minutes. So 1/4 of 60 minutes will be 15 minutes. So all the interior angles should be subtracted by 15 minutes. So by subtracting 15 minutes from all the interior angles, you will get the correct interior angles. Now reverse the calculation. So using the interior angles, you know how to calculate the correct bearings, or you know how to calculate the bearings when the interior angles are given. So you have even solved problems on it. So using such a technique, you are going to find out the correct bearings, right? So let us see how the first method is used to solve the problem. So I have a problem here. So the problem is given like this. The following bearings were observed while traversing with a compass. So there is a table given: line, four bearing and back bearing. So line AB, BC, CD and DE. So looking at this, you can easily say that it is a open traverse. So in the video coming with the solution after this slide, so in the video you can understand what is open traverse and what is closed traverse. Right, so it is clearly explained there. So here, along with the data, you have the four bearing and back bearing given. So there are four lines, and for all the four lines there are four bearings and back bearings given, and he mentioned he has given the problem as mention which stations were affected by local attraction and determine the corrected bearings. So here in this problem, you are supposed to identify which station has got local attraction and you are supposed to find out the correct bearings. So there are 5 stations: station A, station B, station C, station D and station E. Out of 5 stations, which stations are affected by local attraction, you should write. And you should even find out the correct bearings, right? So how this problem is to be solved, I have the separate video made where I am going to show in the video with the blackboard kind of teaching. So I request everyone to go through that particular video and understand how such a problem has to be solved. Right, so it is clearly been explained in the video with the table, with an extra table. Let us see how the problem is going to be solved in that particular video. Such a problem will be asked in your examination for minimum 8 to 12 marks. So it is very compulsory kind of question in your question paper. So I request everyone to understand the way of solving the problem. So not only these kind of problems will be asked, like the one which is given here in the problem is open traverse problem. So there may be a problem given where the traverse might be a closed traverse. Sometimes instead of giving you these fore bearings and back bearings in whole circle bearing system, they may give you in quadrantal bearing system, right? So you should know the solution for all the types of problems. So in the video right now, what we have is the solution for the problem which has got open traverse and the bearings are given in whole circle bearing system. There may be a problem given where there may be even magnetic declination will also be given. So when magnetic declination will be given, they will ask you to find out the true bearings. You know what is true bearing? True bearing means the bearing or the angle, horizontal angle between the line and the true meridian. So the one which I am talking here is magnetic meridian, because the bearings are given with respect to magnetic meridian. So these are magnetic bearings. So when they ask you to find out the true bearings, then the declination will be given to you, and you know how to find out the true bearing when the declination is given, right? So such a problem will also be solved in your future class. So I request everyone to understand the way of solving the problem with the video, and the link will be given in the next slide. So this is the link for the video where the lecture is given on how to solve the problem with the help of the Blackboard. Along with this, I will also have one more video on the next different types of problems. Before that, I request everyone to solve at least one or two problems on a similar kind of problem. So go through the question paper and try to have similar set of problems solved. So you should at least solve two problems your own so that you understand how the problem will be solved. So it is not that easy, but I request everyone to go through the topic and try to solve the problem your own, and try to have the better knowledge before we start with the next type of problem. Okay, so kindly click on the link or just go through the description of this video. So in the description of this video, I have the link given for the solution of the problem. So click on that particular link, you will be able to see the solution for the problem. Thank you.